Hey guys, Blueoriontiger here. So congratulations to me and this channel. This is the first time we actually have a complete video game playthrough uploaded. The last upload of Whispering Willows just went live tonight, and by the time you're watching this video, it'll be live and updated for you to see. So hopefully you did enjoy that. I know some people on Reddit did like. So please do enjoy. I had lots of fun with that game. Now for game new. This time I did jump on the new game bandwagon to do a playthrough. But Blueoriontiger, you say, you're not doing Mass Effect. If so, what are you playing? Well, I'm playing, it should probably have hype, maybe? But a series that I've really liked since probably I was a teenager. 17, 18 years old. And that series is called Syberia. Now, Syberia is basically the gist of it. Is a woman who goes to this little country in Europe, and she's selling this toy factory for which a lady died. But the lady has a brother, and the brother's alive, so she can't sell it. She has to get permission from the brother first. And it turns out that this brother is in the middle of Russia and Siberia, looking for Siberia, not the one with the I, the one with the Y, and is looking for the famed mammoth and believing that they're alive. Now, there's nothing to spoil for this, as this game is well over a decade and a half old, but Kate goes on this journey, manages to sell the toy factory not, and finally finds hands and does find out that yes, mammoths are alive, they are real. And this brother Hans goes off to live with the mammoths, and that was the end of the story. And everybody said, oh, okay, so that's the end, okay, we want more though. So the author, Benoit Sokal, Benoit, I think that's how you say it. He's French. Apologies, Mr. Sokal. He kept promise, yes, I will make a trilogy. I'll make a third installment. Because everybody loved Kate. Everybody loved the puzzles, even though they're a little confusing at times. The story, the art. This guy, his art really drives the game. And I remember even up to ETSU, there started rumors started going around that, yes, Siberia's Tree was coming out, and it was going to be a totally new generation of game based on systems at the time. And it would be like Assassin's Creed, open world. And I'm like, oh my goodness, this isn't a point-and-click adventure game, is it? So, then I see what happens with E3, the launch trailers, and stuff, and finally, I said, if it's going to be a release game that I'm going to get, it is going to be this. And if I'm going to show you guys a game playthrough, rather than backlog you with a bunch of little indie games that have been around for a bit, why not join me as we all plunge into Syberia Tree? I don't know how many of you are fans of the game, but I am, and I do like it, and I'm definitely rooting for Kate and to see what she gets mixed up in. So, let's get going. Syberia awaits. Okay, here we go. Actually, I've reverted to a controller because I got a warning that this is best played with controller. So, we'll go with that and see what happens. But, okay. Beautiful so far. I am pressing the A button. Okay, seriously, what the heck? Okay, so here we go. Nice music. It's kind of actually a little speechless. And that's right, nostalgia trip. I was just thinking about the old game. Okay, so let's pick an adventure. Looking pretty cute around the corner. I don't like. What is a header for my block cereal? Okay. Yeah. Say, voyage or adventure. You play for story for and have clues, or you want to enjoy all the sensations of the first two Syberia games. Okay, we'll go with voyage because I've actually had trouble finding clues, so let's be a little easy on ourselves this time. Confirm. Save this game mode. Yes. Oh, what's this? There's like a bird in the corner? Like a fluffy thing. It's like, It runs so funny, though. It's kind of cute. Dum-de-dum-dum, in my corner, not doing anything. So yeah, I forgot how I played this game first, but I believe it was my sister who actually bought it from a bargain bin at Staples. And, okay, thank you. An owl with a backpack. Those are the bird tunes. Okay, I know it's supposed to be a little artistic, but she's freezing. She could use help a little faster. Okay. Oh, there's that dog thing. So these are probably locals from the second Syberia that the tribe that knew about mammoths and Kate had gotten the heart from. And all of you may have a little, each bird has a little house. European architecture. It's going to mean one thing.
3 months ago, nomads found her dying in northern Syberia. Walker. Kate Walker. Born in New York in the United States. She had an American passport on her. She showed up at the clinic last week. She's recovering. She's fine.
You're certain, Olga Efimova? You have to keep her there until we arrive.
I will do what it takes. You can count on me, Colonel.
Oh, wow. It's just the animation itself, it's...
Hello, Kate Walker.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
My name is Kirk, Kate Walker. Kirk of the Yukol tribe.
Oh, I pronounced it wrong.
Do you remember the Yukols?
Where are we? My memory's all mixed up. There was a terrible blizzard with snow and ice, and then nothing.
We are in the clinic of Dr. Zamyatin, in the town of Valsambor.
How did I end up here?
We Yukos migrate with our snow ostriches to the sacred lands.
Oh.
It's a long journey. A very special journey. 1 month ago, we found you dying on a riverbank there in the north. We took you in and our shaman cared for you. Afterwards, we continued our journey. And today... we are both here to finish getting better.
Okay.
What's wrong, Kate?
You lost a leg.
It was an accident, you know. Some people don't like nomads like us. But don't worry about me. Dr. Zamyatin asked a master craftsman from Velsimbor to make me a new leg, and he's going to put it on me when it's ready. It will be like a brand new leg.
Why are you tied to that bed?
That was the decision of Madame Olga, Dr. Zamyatin's assistant. She says I'm too restless, and it's the only way to make sure I get better. Apparently, it's going to take a long time to make my artificial leg. And in the meantime, my people are without a guide and are waiting for me, with the herd, so we can continue.
The migration. I was thinking of migration.
Why do the Yukels make the journey?
My people live in symbiosis with the great snow ostriches, Kate Walker. Their wool protects us from the cold. Their excrement feeds our crops, and their meat feeds us. They are also our mounts and beasts of burden, so we must follow them wherever they go.
And do they migrate because of the weather?
No, Kate Walker. They go to the sacred lands to reproduce. It is an event that only occurs a few times per century. For the Yukols, it is rare to be able to boast of having participated in more than three migrations during one's lifetime.
Okay, so they're kind of like reindeer, sort of, like with those kind of tribes that migrate after them.
The Yukels I've met didn't speak my language anywhere near as well as you. I'm very impressed.
From time to time, missionaries and merchants came through our village. I learned very quickly, Kit Walker. It's important if I am to guide my people.
I don't mean to be rude, Kirk, but aren't you a bit young for that?
The spirits do not take age into account when they choose a chief for the Yukols. And the spirits are very wise. They do not make mistakes when they choose the one who will guide our people on the sacred migration.
I like doing that. Okay, well, let's ask about your leg, and then we'll see what else you have to say.
If you don't mind my asking about your leg, what exactly happened to you?
Soldiers bombed the route we were taking with our caravan. For no reason. Just to frighten us and force us to turn back.
What the heck?
I was a bit too close to the explosion. A piece of rock. That's it.
You mean the authorities did it on purpose? But why?
They think that the snow ostrich migration has no place in today's world, and that my tribe should settle down once and for all. But we will never do that, Kate Walker. That would mean defying the spirits. And the Yukols fear the spirits far more than the soldiers.
Well, Kirk, I'm delighted to have made your acquaintance. I guess I have to go tell the staff that I'm awake, I feel fine, and I have no intention of hanging around here.
Of course, Kate Walker. I'm sure someone will be in the yard. Maybe even Madame Olga.
Okay. So, let's, take this in for a minute. Okay, so that's how you move. This sounds like Kate's original voice actor, a little aged. This is fully 3D rendered. This is not puppet. This is actually a 3D scene. And so what we understand here is what happened is after Kate led Hans to the mammoths, and mammoths left. Apparently, Kate, shortly after that, it looks like, she got frozen or in an accident or something, and his tribe, the Yukols, got her and brought her to the hospital. So she's doing better now, and that's a month from that time. And, so, if that timeline is correct, this would mean this would still be back in, like, late 90s, early 2001. So, this isn't, you're not going to be, I shouldn't be expecting any modern, you know, cell phone and stuff like smartphones. This would still be, like, flip phones, square computer monitors, like we saw with that nurse lady over there and stuff. So, Kate's model doesn't look too bad. I'm a lot more detailed than the other one. She has that Kate look. She still kind of sounds a little prissy from being a New York lawyer, but she cares. She does have a soft spot for the mammoths and the yokels when she was trying to find Hans and stuff. So it's nice to see that that is there. So now that we recapped all of that and I like how it's going, let's just take it from there. It's going to be cinematic, so I'm not going to really, if there's dialogue or something, unless it really makes me raise an eyebrow, like, use the poop from the bird ostrich, I'm not going to, like, disturb that or for your own benefit. So, yeah, let's see what's in this hospital room. I'm going to guess we're going to be somewhere in, like, a Russian kind of, like, a state. Oh, okay. So if you need something, put your mouse over. Oh, okay. We can kind of look, too. Okay, let's click here.
What? Hello? Is anybody there?
I don't think anybody heard you, Kate Walker. Try using the call button that's located next to the door.
Come on, Kate. That was the most prissy, hello, is anybody there? That is so Kate, so really. Except she would be like, I don't know. Push the button.
Nothing. It doesn't work, Kirk.
I think I saw some of the staff using it the other day. Take a good look at the mechanism, Kate Walker. Maybe you can find a way to get it working again.
Now, not to be super critical, her eyebrows don't seem to be moving a whole lot. I don't know if that's a bug, but it's, it takes away a little bit, so it seems more like a puppet, but it's not Uncanny Valley with, Mass Effect Andromeda. At least the other stuff kind of makes up for it. And the Yoko Boy's stuff moves too. So I'm hoping it is a bug. Because I don't think Benoit would just not animate people's eyebrows. So, okay. Let's see what's this.
Bolted tight.
Yeah, typical Kate fashion. Yeah, it's bolted tight. So we'll need something in the room to probably... untighten it? Oh, wait, what's their tools? Oh, we can go out here, okay. Oh, okay. Kind of like look from a vantage point, and you scroll around, with pan by moving your mouse to one end of the screen.
What's that owl doing here?
That's an owl? Owl, why you do this?
Kirk's tribe's camp, I guess.
Is there anything else this way? Well, she is stumbling around barefoot, I guess, so I don't know. Well, there's a bucket. Okay, let's go back this one.
You should go for a walk in the yard, Kate Walker. That door leads right to it.
Is there anything this way? Maybe at this table? Because this is going to be one flop of a playthrough if there's bugs and I can't play, or it doesn't work. Let's look back at this. No?
Bolted tight.
Uh-huh. Okay, it shows me how bad I am at puzzle games sometimes.
This diagram shows how to turn the call button on, but I can't do anything until I can get at the internal mechanism.
Search the room. I'm sure you'll be able to find something you can use to open it up with.
Yes, Kate. Use your head. Come on, you're a lawyer from New York that went all the way to Siberia to look for mammoths, which scientists can't even do. You can definitely use your head. If only that I wasn't using your head for you, and I can't seem to figure out how to open it. Oh, now it... There we go. Choose an interaction. Okay. Oh, that's Oscar's heart. There was, for people who didn't play previous Syberia, there was a automaton that Kate would follow that helped run their clockwork train to take him to Siberia. And in the end, Oscar gave up himself to become like an exosuit for Hans. So this is what made Oscar run. So it's nice, it's sweet that she's hanging on to that to remember Oscar. Okay. Observe. Did he use?
That should do the trick quite nicely. Now try to use it to see if you can repair the call button.
Gotta fix it up. Oh, now I get why they said controller. Okay, I'm have to move my mouse in like a circular
thing here. Let's see if I can repair the mechanism.
If you're not sure, maybe the diagram you saw earlier might help.
Okay, go back. Oh, dang it. Physics wires! Bouncy, bouncy. Okay. Okay, let's try this. Okay, I need to get... back somehow. And... well, it's fixed. Back. Okay, just scroll. So is this. We have to put the thing back up somehow. And I am not sure how to do that. Still, it's in an inventory? try using that or something. Unless I'm missing something. Okay, there we go. Here goes nothing.
Finally! Right, now I just have to find a supervisor.
Well done, Kate Walker. I'm going to have a bit of a rest now. Please try to come back and say goodbye to me before you go.
Typical Syberia fashion. This sure ain't Kansas, okay. Right. And you still run at the same speed from the first two Syberia games, okay. I can put up with that, I guess? I mean, come on, you're running like this little polite jog team. You're in the middle of the, it doesn't hurt to just, you know, gallop like that, but I don't know.
Go hold your head under the ice water in the fountain, Nikita. That'll clear up your damn headaches.
Not his time. This isn't a normal headache. It's like a pile of rusty nails rattling in my skull.
Ah, that guy had the
Well, that's you settled then. Did you speak to Madame Olga or Dr. Mongoline?
No. Because maybe they're the ones sticking the damn nails in my head while I'm asleep.
The only thing the doctors want is for us to get better.
Have you seen the mammoths, too?
We'll go see the birds in the aviary.
Go tell the
later.
Staff that way. Maybe
it
they'll believe me.
You down.
And have you seen any dragons, too?
I've seen mammoths, mister, but not dragons. Oh, okay. That's probably where we might need to go.
So, this guy so you're finally awake. Has Dr. Olga been informed?
Get your bearings. I understood that you'd be staying with us for a little while yet.
You don't sound like you're local to Russia, Mr. Oh, that's a creepy face a little bit. Don't stare at me, dude. I'm just in... I'm not even dressed. And you're just there staring at me. The eyes follow you! Oh my goodness! Okay. Nothing here? Okay, we'll leave the two dudes alone by themselves and go back to look for something.
I really tried. I tried to tell them I was a whole lot better. They just wouldn't listen.
Sounds like something fishy is going on at this hospital. Is it in this corner? No? Okay. I'm gonna guess that's locked. Automatons. Wounded automatons act like real birds. You don't have to feed them. You don't have, well, probably oil them and just wind them up, I guess. Interesting. Gonna guess those are like canned royal birds kind of stuff. Okay, do you feel polite, Runner? We just need to get somewhere. Good talk to you.
The light, the wind, the heat. I can still feel it all. I dream of it every night.
Okay, so we came from this one.
Someone should have a word with the maintenance department.
No, I'm just talking to you, won't do anything. Can I open this door? Yes.
Dr. Mangling.
Ah, you're finally awake, number 10. What can I do for you?
Well, it seems to me that I'm cured. And now I'd like to be on my way.
Given your condition, that would seem somewhat premature and perhaps even unreasonable, number 10.
Condition?
I am not a number. My name is Kate Walker. I would appreciate it if you would call me by my name, Doctor.
Sassy.
There's a perfect example. That aggression boiling up within you. I'm afraid that it may be a significant traumatic after effect.
So you're refusing to let me leave?
Oh, no, of course not, miss. I have no intention of abusing any of the prerogatives of my position. Nonetheless, first you must submit to a series of tests that are designed to demonstrate that you have fully recovered.
Yeah.
You understand. Please, sit down.
On that?
Yes, yes. Don't be afraid.
What the?
Yeah, I'm guessing she's too polite to say swear words either, so...
Don't worry about these restraints. Merely a simple formality that's part of the protocol that Dr. Olga, our supervisor, has implemented. Right. I do believe that we can begin. Now, be so kind as to state your first and last names, age, and place of birth, please. I'm beginning to...
My name is Kate Walker. I was born in New York, and I'll be 30 this year.
Oh, she's my age.
Good, good, miss. Up until now, my device would seem to corroborate what you say.
You're using a lie detector?
It's procedure. Please stop worrying and talk to me instead of your friends and family. Are you on good terms with them?
No. I cut off with them. I haven't had any news from my mother for weeks. And Dan, my fiancé, left me for my best friend Olivia.
You seem to be basking in this chaos and anarchy, Miss Walker. Is this inclination for disorder connected to this Hans Vorarlberg and Oscar? You spoke about them at length while you were delirious.
Oscar was an automaton and Hans Vorarlberg was the person who made him. We became friends, and I went with them on a long journey through Europe. There you have it.
To be honest, what I'm interested in, Miss Walker, is that during your travels you were in contact with the Yuko people, the nomads who brought you here to Velzimbor. In your opinion, what should we fear from such a primitive tribe of savages who understand neither law nor border? Refusing
okay.
Civilization and settlement.
Stand by, we have technical difficulties. And this is what you get with day one launches, boys and girls. Please stand by.
To be honest, what I'm interested in, Miss Walker, is that during your travels you were in contact with the Yuko people.
Okay.
The nomads who...
So, apparently, and it's okay, there's nothing on my desktop that I'm hiding from you, this game is a dud beyond that point. Now, I'm going to go check the forums quick and see if there's anything to be done. But if that's not the case, this is a letdown. And honestly, this is a... I haven't had such an experience like this for a release game. I mean, I bought Witness, I think... 4 days after it came out, and it didn't do all this nonsense. And I'm going to give you an honest opinion here. I don't know if it's a PC thing, but in the demo at E3 or wherever they had this game playing, they only played up to this point. You can take that for what it is. You can look at No Man's Sky and point a finger. But they did not play the game. They did not want to, oh, we did not want to show the game, spoil story and whatever. But they never got past the scene when showing. I don't know if that has anything to do with it. So, yeah, that's just going to quit here today. And it's to give these person credit, this wallpaper is by laovan@deviantart.com. So go shout at them and tell them that they popped up on YouTube by accident because Syberia Tree crashed. Because somebody talking about yokels didn't get to finish their sentence. So, obviously, it seems like the game works at that point, but they, yeah. So, if I don't get it working again, I'll just see you next time.